She'll see you at once.
They're sick people, not criminals.
We've gone beyond that question, Your Majesty. They're
my citizens, and we will save them from the plague if we can. All of them.
Very well.
We will not speak of this again.
Mother, Corvo is back.
Thank you, Emily. Leave us, please.
As you wish, Your Majesty. Corvo, 2 days early, full of surprises, as usual.
It's a fair wind that brings you home to me. What news have you brought? Thank you. If you hadn't been here...
No more! Not again!
Mommy! No!
Get away from her!
Corvo! Mommy! Get away! Corvo!
Corvo! It's all coming apart. Find Emily. Protect her. You're the only one who'll know what to do. Won't you? Corvo.
Ward us all. Look at what he's done.
Yes, he's killed the Empress. What did you do with young Lady Emily, traitor?
Her own bodyguard. Ironic.
I'll see you beheaded for this, Corvo. Peg him.
You should eat, Corvo. This meal comes from a friend.
You think he had help? Who'd know how to do that?
Bottle Street gang, maybe. Watch for booby traps. There'll be some down here by the look of it.
Get past me, sir. Do you know who we're hunting here? Her son.
Dunwall citizen, the assassin Corvo, responsible for the murder of our fair empress and the
Corvo, over here.
I'm Samuel, and I work for some good people who want very much to meet you. They said you'd come out here. I can still hardly believe it. I'll take you to meet them. Just down the river from here. This is the Hound Pit's pub. Closed for business. Half the district marked off as dead from the plague. We're right under the Lord Regent's nose, and he don't know a thing. Of course, if anyone finds out what we're up to, the Watch will break in with swords drawn. And now that you've escaped, the Lord Regent's going to be tearing the city apart. Take you up to meet Admiral Havelock and the rest of the loyalists. The Admiral's a man to be reckoned with. If anyone can help you find that missing girl, Lady Emily, and clear your name, he can.
So it's starting at last.
We can continue this later. Yes. Piero's as much an artist.
Are you gonna use anchor from upstairs or from these wires in a different place? Careful. Wild and stable. Perfect. Tell me what I can make for you. You must be exhausted. I advise that you get some sleep. Your life will get even more difficult soon. You should rest while you can. Sleep well. What can I do for you?
Just give the signal. It'll be a rough trip. Used to be to go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy. Half the city's dead of the plague. The other half's fighting over what's left. City Watch still holds the bigger streets, and they've set up those wall of light checkpoints. A man walks through one of those, and he ends up burned to a crisp. Everything not controlled by the City Watch is gang territory. There are the real odd birds living on the fringes, like that Granny Rags. They say she's nuts. I don't know which is worse. Just take your pick.
Let's go.
Let's go. Admiral Havelock and Lord Pendleton are in the courtyard. I expect they'll want to congratulate you.
Corvo.
Pendleton's waiting for you on the dock.
Only thought.
Corvo. I'll take you to the Golden Cat when you're ready.
I've taken Lord Pendleton enough times, believe me. I'll get you as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo. You'll have to go the rest of the way on your own. The entrance is near Holger Square. The main thing is to make sure that little girl, Emily, gets back all safe and sure. Them two Pendletons are there, so I'm guessing there'll be a lot of guards. Slackjaw might have some ideas on helping you get inside the cat, if he don't kill you. This here's his territory. He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall Whiskey Factory. They sell the elixir that folks use to fight off the plague. I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you bring him back. Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you.
Pendletons are here. You're supposed
ready to go.
Corvo, you must have worked wonders out there in the city tonight. I can't believe my old eyes. So you did the business, did you, Corvo? I'm not one to speak against my betters, mind you, but if anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those Pendletons.
What business are you talking about?
Oh, I grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Oh. I should concentrate on piloting this boat.
Thank you.
Young Lady Emily, I'm Callista. I'll be caring for you and schooling you while you're with us.
Pleased to meet you.
As am I. Would you like to see your room in the tower?
Can I see it?
Yes, you may. You'll get to see it all. The entirety of the Hound Pits.
Good. I think I'll like it here. I'll go with Callista, Corvo. I'll see you later.
You do not fail to impress. Armed with a blade, you've changed the course of the city forever. And with the Pendleton twins gone, our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament. In one night, you've done more than most men do in a lifetime. I need to speak to you soon. But for now, Lord Pendleton requests your attention.
Corvo, the Loyalists can...
All right, my
friend. Did I faint or something?
Off to Caldwin's Bridge, sir.
We'll get our sleep later. Just climb aboard when you're ready.
What do you think, Corvo? Caldwin's Bridge. Been in the city for years, but you lived in Dunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right. We'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive. He's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole of Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions, and the like. Seems dangerous to me. But what do I know? Set up a cell for Sokolov in the old kennel. Shackles and everything. It'll be a shock, him waking up in the straw and old dog poop. But from what I hear, he's woken up worse places. Guess we all have at that.
While you were sleeping. I decided to nap here in your room while Callista was taking her bath. She told me if there's ever trouble, I should always run here. Callista...
Royal, you're part of this...
costume ball, huh? Well, that'll be fun, but not for everybody. You ready?
Stops for the Boyle family. I didn't think there'd be tall boys patrolling here tonight. Watch yourself, Corvo. They don't fool around. The good news is, once you get to the party, that mask of yours will let you blend right in. Enjoy your evening out with the folk of quality. Better you than me.
You enjoyed your evening, sir.
But we'd best be on our way. Quickly. Pendleton said he would meet us here. I checked the wine cellar. Losing family gives a man a thirst.
You did it.
And now we've done away with a woman, and a noble woman at that. But Boyle was a viper. She helped the Lord Regent kill the Empress. So I don't feel a thing for her. You've had a long night, Corvo. But I fear it's not over. Havelock and Marden have already cooked up something more for you. They would like to see you now. In Havelock's chambers above the bar.
Attention.
Corvo.
Streets adjacent.
The Boyle Manor remain armed.
Ready to face the Lord Regent? About time we took care of my say. Long past time. Oh my. This is it, Corvo. Your last memories of Dunwall Tower might not be good ones, huh? So maybe you can make up for what happened back then. Be a bit of a climb from the water lot. Most important thing is killing the Lord Regent. Built himself quite a place at the top of the tower. Calls it his safe room or something. Crazy if you ask me. Another point of interest while I'm giving you the grand tour, Corvo. Broadcast control station here where all them announcements come from. Might be worth looking into. Ready? Next time I see you, the Lord Regent will be dead. And if not, well, it was an honor to serve with you. Is it all done?
You ready to go back to the Hound Pits? Thanks to you, Corvo. All right, let's go. Big changes. Makes me uneasy, to tell the truth. A small fry like me always gets the worst of it. But maybe it's going to be different now. The Lord Regent is gone. The Abbey has a new High Overseer. I'm guessing our work is almost done. The others are in the bar. No doubt waiting to raise a glass in your name. Me, I think I'll just linger out here if you don't mind. Reflect on things while we have a moment. Congratulations, Corvo.
This is the one who was with the Empress when she died. Poisoned. Tivian stuff.
Amateur work. He'll live.
That's up to doubt.
Talks to you in the dark. Talks to you when you visit his shrines. I visited those shrines too. And I know what it felt like to shove a blade into your empress. But I don't know you. Who you are, and who you fight for. You're a mystery. And I can't allow that.
Thank you.
find you here.
Never pays to bet against you, does it?
There's one more trick across the river.
That's one more. This is it, sir. I suspect Havelock Martin and Lord Pendleton landed there a while ago and went into the lighthouse. Knowing them, they're not giving up without a fight. I remember hearing the Admiral and Martin talking about this place as where they'd hold up if they had to. Anybody going in has to breach the fort, the gatehouse, and there's only one way to the top. All I can say is that it's been a pleasure serving with you. Maybe after all this is settled, we'll see each other again. Good luck, Corvo. If anyone deserves it, you do. Give my best.
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin I will take her mother's throne after a season of turmoil. You will stand at her side, Corvo, guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek to exploit her or cause her harm. You watched and listened when other men would have shouted in rage. You held back instead of striking. So it is, with the passing of the plague and Emily's ascension, comes a golden age brought about by your hand. Decades hence, when your hair turns white and you pass from this world, Empress Emily, Emily the Wise, at the height of her power, will lay your body down within her mother's great tomb, because you are more to her than royal protector. Farewell, Corvo.
Long enough for all of the big and the small, well, that's all that they stand.